A function is a reusable code block that will execute only when it's called. To create one, we use the function keyword followed by a name, an optional parameter list and a code block. We can then call the function from anywhere on the page by typing its name followed by a set of parentheses. The function names are case insensitive, but it's a good standard to use the same casing as they have in their declaration. The parentheses after the function name can be used to pass arguments to the function. To do this, we must first add them to the function declaration in the form of a comma-separated list. We can then use the arguments in the function just as any other variable. Make sure to call the function with the same number of arguments. We can also specify default values for the arguments by assigning them a value inside the parameter list. Now, if we don't specify that argument when calling the method, the default value will be used instead. For this to work as expected, it's important that the default values are to the right of the other arguments. If we call a method with too few arguments, we will get an error, but there's nothing to stop us from passing more arguments than we've defined in the function. This allows us to pass a variable number of arguments, which can be accessed using some built-in functions. To get one argument at a time, we can use this function, which takes a single value, the parameter to be returned. There's also two more functions, one to get the number of arguments passed, and another to get an array containing all of the arguments. An important keyword we can use in functions is return, which will cause the function to exit. It can also be given a value to return, and will then make the function call evaluate to that value. By default, function arguments are passed by value. This means that if the value of the argument is changed, it doesn't get changed outside of the function. To allow a function to modify an argument, it must instead be passed by reference. This is done by adding an ampersand before the argument's name in the function's definition. Normally, a variable in PHP exists throughout the life of that page and can therefore be used anywhere in the script. However, within functions, a local function scope is now introduced. Any variable inside of a function is by default limited to this scope, so trying to access a global variable will not work. In order to make a global variable available, we need to extend the scope of that variable to the method by declaring it global. Another useful keyword is static, which makes the function remember the variable. A static variable exists only in a local function scope, but it does not lose its value when the function ends. We can, for example, use this to make a counter. Since the advantage of functions is that they are reusable, we often want to use the same functions on multiple pages. This can be done by first placing the function code inside a separate file, and then including it using the include function. This function takes all the text in the specified file and includes it, just as if the code had been typed on the current page.